everybody. My name is Kozmitch, and welcome to the Beginner's Guide. Now, if you've played the Stanley Parable, this is supposed to be kind of like that. It's created by one of the same authors of the Stanley Parable. So, I have a feeling we're going to get some mind twists and stuff with an awesome narration, because that was one cool thing about Stanley Parable was that narrator. So without further ado, let's go. Please make sure audio is on. You damn right it's on. Alright, that was simple.
Hi there.
Hi.
Thank you very much for playing the Beginner's Guide.
No problem.
My name is Davey Reedon. I wrote the Stanley Parable. And while that game tells a pretty absurd story, today I'm going to tell you about a series of events that happened between 2008 and 2011.
All right.
We're going to look at the games made by a friend of mine named Coda. Now, these games mean a lot to me. I met Coda in early 2009 at a time when I was really struggling with some personal stuff, and his work pointed me in a very powerful direction. I found it to be a good reference point for the kinds of creative works that I wanted to make. So just to start you off, this is, I think, the first game he ever made. It's a level for Counter-Strike. You can walk around here, by the way.
Oh, really?
And mostly it's just Coda learning the basics of building a 3D environment. But what I like is that even though he starts from the simple aesthetic of a desert town, he then scatters these colorful abstract blobs and impossible floating crates around the level. And of course, it destroys the illusion that this actually is a desert town, and instead this level becomes a kind of calling card from its creator. It's like a reminder that this video game was constructed by a real person. And it kind of makes you wonder, what was going through his head as he was building this? This is what I like about all of Coda's games. I mean, not that they're all fascinating as games, but that they are all going to give us access to their creator. I want us to see past the games themselves. I want to get to know who this human being really is.
Yeah, let's do that.
And that's exactly what we're going to do here.
Sweet.
So, it's 2008, Coda starts making these games, and he never releases any of them. He doesn't put them onto the internet, he just makes them and then immediately abandons them and they sit on his computer forever. And I think he really understood this image of himself as a recluse. At one point, he jokingly renamed his computer's recycling bin to Important Games Folder. So, you know, this was just how he worked. He tended to crank them out one after the other without even really pausing to try to understand what he had just made, until suddenly one day, he just stopped. In 2011, that was it. He made his last game, and then he hasn't made another one since. And that's why I've taken this opportunity to gather all of his work together, is because I find his games powerful and interesting, and I'd like this collection to reach him, to maybe encourage him to start creating again. And if the people like you who play this also happen to find his work interesting, then I'm sure it'll just send that much stronger of a message of encouragement to Coda. So thanks for joining me on this. If you have a particular interpretation that I haven't mentioned here, or if you just need to get in touch, you can email me at daveywreden@gmail.com. Okay, that's about it for introduction. Let's take a look at Coda's first proper game.
All right, let's do it.
As each game is loading, I'll show you the date that it was completed. This first one was made in November 2008.
Oh, this is different. 100%. Oh, God. Oh, okay. Can I go this way?
This game is called Escape from Whisper, and it's one of the more generic games you'll see from Coda.
Ah. Are we gonna be fighting some beasts?
You can click to fire the gun.
Gun doesn't reload.
Security hole breached. Hostile alien life form inbound.
It kind of looks like this game was abandoned mid-development. For instance, you have this gun, which you'd think would indicate that there are supposed to be monsters or enemies somewhere. But then clearly there are no enemies anywhere. You can't even reload the gun when you run out of bullets. But ultimately, we don't really know. Maybe Koda thought that actually it was complete the way that it is. And I think that we should talk about his games for what they are, rather than for what they're not.
Sure.
I love how you can see the bottom of the universe from this room.
To the game floor. Oh gosh.
Apparently this space station has a labyrinth on it. I don't know. There's really no reason for it that I've ever been able to discern, so in the interest of time, I'm just gonna skip you on past it.
Oh, okay.
Okay, this is the part that's interesting. The game has this narrative about the whisper machine and how it has to be turned off, and then you get to the engine room.
That's a sick looking engine.
You there, in the engine room. You could save us all. That beam is powering the whisper machine. We could disrupt it by introducing a great enough heat signature. If you... your body could stop the beam.
Oh, I'm the heat signature?
It's so much to ask, but for all of our lives, would you do it? Could you give yourself?
I don't know, man. I just met you, and I just got here, and fuck it. I'll do it.
Let me pause here for a second.
Okay.
What you just experienced, stepping into the beam and then dying, is probably what Koda had initially intended when he was developing this level. But when he first compiles and plays it, something goes wrong. There's a bug somewhere.
Okay.
And this is what happens instead.
Do I live? What happened? Oh, okay. Whoa.
The beam causes you to start floating.
Cool.
And this is an important moment for him. Because yes, this is technically a glitch, but Koda identifies something human about it. Like how small it makes you feel in the face of this larger chaotic system. Or this floating could be the afterlife, a peaceful place, juxtaposed against all of the hysteria that you've just had to traverse. I don't even know. I have no idea what he was thinking, but what's clear is that after making this, something lodges itself in his brain. He wants to do more of these really weird and experimental designs. So he stops work on this and moves on to a stream of tiny little games that go in all sorts of directions. Let's go ahead and take a look at the first
things?
Game he made after leaving this one behind.
I could have made it through there. Okay, I can't move. Oh.
Yep. In this game, you can only walk backwards.
That's weird. Passes behind her.
So it's a short and relatively minimalist experiment combining motion and narrative. It is less advanced than the previous game, but actually it seems to be more focused, more complete. Code is trying to give it a unique voice rather than simply basing it on a pre-existing trope.
Clear. But if the future is always behind her, how will she find the strength to confront it?
It's a short little thought, it says what it wants to say, and then it ends. Didn't need anything more than that. Which to me is why it works, because it gets out quick.
Yeah, it does.
Okay, next one.
Okay. Okay. Didn't think he'd have a horror game. You are now entering. Entering what? What am I entering? Oh, okay.
And that's it.
Oh.
Okay, the meaning of this game won't be clear just yet. Please be patient with me for a few more games, and I promise you'll see what makes it interesting.
Okay. Now it's December.
Oftentimes, Koda would put bizarre titles like this one at the start of his games.
Okay. Nonsense and nearly everything.
I wish I'd known him at the time that he was making these early games. He would really only talk to me about his work as he was making it. Once he stopped work on a game, like, that was it. It was dead to him. And I don't agree with that at all, but what are you gonna do?
Up the stairs. Why am I slowing down?
Once you've been slowed to an absolute crawl, the door at the top of the stairs opens. So why, if Coda's not showing these games to anyone, why bother opening the door at all? Well, to show you, I'm modifying the game here so that when you press enter, it'll bring you back up to full speed so you can enter the door for yourself.
Enter. Oh, there we go. Oh. Staring at a bear for 3 hours. Game of only motivational quotes, play one after the other while the player cannot move. You stare in a small room until you realize you can just walk through the walls. Ooh, that's
and
cool.
Nice and filled with little ideas for games.
Game filled with chairs, except one chair is floating. Sharks are trying to eat you simultaneously, we're trying to eat the shark.
Coda would often tell me that he didn't mind if people thought of him as cold or distant. He said that he knew that he was actually a vibrant and compassionate person, but that it takes time to really see that.
Play as the camera.
It can be a very slow climb to get there.
On the set, filming whatever you like. The button you press to stop chaos that doesn't work. Dusting your jewelry while the kingdom is destroyed. Okay. Ready, set, fish. Am I going fishing? There's a door. I don't see any water. The nice hardwood stairs.
Well, this is new for Coda. It's an actual puzzle. Go ahead and see if you can solve it.
Okay. If I go behind you, well, it's closer.
Don't forget that solution, because we're going to see this puzzle again soon. We're gonna see it a lot.
What does that mean? Three dots? Boing.
So that seems to be it, right? You walk down a corridor, you solve a puzzle, you get to the end. Simple enough. All right.
I was promised fishing.
Now I'm going to modify the game again, so that when you press enter, it'll remove all of the walls from this room.
Like that? Whoa!
How about that? There was more to it
huge.
Than we had any way of knowing.
I've never even been
I actually
over
find
there.
It funny that this game comes after the stairs game, since they essentially convey the opposite idea. So, in the stairs game, a dull exterior concealed a rich interior. And then, in this level, a dull interior hides this fantastic outer world. Either way, I think that the point is the same, is that most of the time you don't get to know what you're missing, or even that you're missing anything. That's not your role as a player. So if your role here is not to understand, then what is it?
That is a good question. Are we back here now? You are now exiting. Oh, I get it.
So this, combined with the entering game from earlier, tells us that Coda believes his games are connected somehow. It could even be that the stairs game and the puzzle game are literally connected in between this and the entering game. There's a bigger picture that all of his games are meant to play a role in, some larger meaning that we won't be able to grasp until we've seen all of them. And once we have, we can step back and start to understand what exactly that bigger picture is.
All right, well, let's keep cranking them out then. Now we're in March. It's 2009 now, I just realized. The Great and Lovely Descent. The music doesn't seem very lovely. It's a nice house.
Let's
you
talk
got
about
here.
Video game development for a second. Every video game
another
runs
cafe.
On what's called an engine, which determines what the game can and cannot do.
It's like a cafe.
So, in other words, the engine is a set of tools for game development. To make all
oh,
of these
games,
Coda is using an engine called Source. Like all engines, like Source has certain things that it does well, and it has certain things that it does poorly.
Cool.
One of the things that it does very well is boxy linear corridors. That's why so many of CUDA's games are set in these large, flat, empty rooms, is just because he's working with what the engine does well. The tools available to the creator shape what kinds of creative work they're going to end up making. You might consider paying attention to the architecture in CUDA's games to notice how they seem to stem from an engine that's very good at producing linear, boxy corridors.
Can I just, like, fall? Whoa! Well, that was a lot faster. Why is that trapped in glass? What is that? Got down here? It's a bullpen? I don't care for this very much. Oh, that music though. Okay, we're going this way. Oh, this is an elevator. Oh, okay. So I'm in jail now.
Funny enough, in CUDA's original design, the door stayed shut for a full hour before letting you go.
Holy shit.
If you don't mind, I think we're gonna skip that.
Yes, please.
This is something that he and I used to argue about a lot. You know, whether a game ought to actually be playable, whether it means anything if no one can get through it. And I would always defend that, you know, all this work goes into the game, why not make it playable and accessible? And so we just got into heated arguments over it, and there was one time that after one of these conversations, he went home, and a day or two later, he sent me a zip file entitled Playable Games that was full of hundreds of individual games, each of which was just an empty box that you walked around in and nothing else. Believe me, I played every single one of those just to find out if there was like a gag hidden somewhere. There wasn't.
Damn, he just proved you wrong. Oh, you don't let me just fall. How many stairs are there? There we go. Oh, now we're what? This makes no sense. Hey,
it's the puzzle again.
Puzzle.
With the exact same solution as the last time.
It better be, otherwise I'd be stuck in here.
There's still no clear indication of what makes this puzzle so special that CUDA is going to return to it over and over. But I promise, I'll share with you my interpretation very shortly.
Because it's simple yet complex enough? I don't know. Hello! Hello. Oh, I love how you talk.
Here, CUDA begins using a kind of dialogue system that he fashioned out of the engine's chat capabilities. Use the 1, 2, 3 buttons on your keyboard to respond.
Yes, there are these floating colored blocks. That's from way up above. Did you have to get through a puzzle with 2 doors and switches? Yes, I did. That was literally the last thing I did before I got here. Please tell us how you solved it. Tell us the solution. Tell us how to get to the other side. Trust me, you don't want to go over there. Oh no, but I do. We do. We need to get there. Do you understand? It's the most important thing in the world. We have to escape this prison. There must be an ending. I promise you, there's nothing I want more. My guess is that there's not actually an ending from what we just heard about CUDA. Oh, okay. Hello again. Now you're in, like, a slumped over position. Was there a puzzle you had to pass through? No, I've been right here this entire time. Hey, I suggest you go and see the puzzle sometime. It's not meant to be solved, but you can set the black space in the middle. It's not meant to be solved? What happens if I solve it? Not sure, but if I have any suspicion that you won't find what sort it takes to get there, you have another chance to solve it soon. Okay. More stairs.
And so we make one last descent down to the final floor of the level.
Oh, it's a light. That's what those are. Hello, lamppost. You're from the beginning.
It's a lamppost.
Yes, it is.
Okay, I can't tell you quite why, but for some reason, Koda fixates on this lamppost. It's going to appear at the end of every single one of his games from here on out. I'll tell you what I think.
I at least have a marker.
I think that up to this point, you know, he's been making really strange and abstract games with no clear purpose, and maybe you can only float around in that headspace for so long. Because now he wants something to hold on to. He wants a reference point. He wants the work to be leading to something. He wants a destination. Which is what this lamppost is. It's a destination. We're gonna see it in the work as well. His games are just gonna become a lot more cohesive, a lot more fully developed, with more of a clear idea behind them.
Well,
and
I
as we
so.
Go, that idea will get clearer and clearer and clearer.
I sure hope so. Game is connected to the internet. As you walk around, you can leave notes. All notes you see are left by other players. That is a nice window. Why'd you make me look at that, though? Nice room. I think it's a lovely room. Look at that.
So first off, I'm sure you can deduce
this,
but
game?
This game is not connected to the internet. All of the notes that
no
you're going
to
see
this.
Have been written by Koda.
Oh, gosh.
This was actually the first game of his that I ever played. This was shortly after I met him at a weekend game jam in Sacramento, where I grew up. I saw him working on this very level, and it was just so different from anything that anyone else was doing. So right away, I was like, I have to be friends with this person.
Can you guys hear me?
In retrospect, I think I was probably a bit too pushy trying to get his attention. I was over-enthusiastic. But he was very gracious about it and very patient with me. And I cooled off eventually.
This place makes me sad. Oh,
feel free to skip over any of these notes if they're not doing anything for you. Nothing extra is going
to
happen if you read all of them.
I want to tell you
either way, to
I
me,
did.
They convey a sense of loneliness. I see this person who's filled with thoughts and feelings and beliefs and has no way to express them. Except as scattered and unheard voices in a game that wasn't meant to be played.
I don't know what that stands for. We're just gonna skip these. This is gonna take way too long.
But it's ironic, isn't it? That in playing this game and seeing how alone Koda often felt, that we get to know him better
and
actually kind of
connect. Sailors are looking for it.
And I have to be honest with you, this idea is really seductive to me. That I could just play someone's game and see the voices in their head and get to know them better
yes,
and have
please.
To do less of the messy in-person socializing.
There's nothing here. Go
I
back.
Could just get to know you through your
Don't
work.
Don't listen to that guy.
I think this is why I always liked Koda's games so much. Is because it felt like they let me have that connection.
A free
I felt as
t-shirt.
Though he was inviting me personally into his world.
Need other side.
And then I feel less lonely too.
Mixed game, clue store, can it open door, thanks. Open sesame. Is it not open? Guess I should have read the notes. Door, how open? Someday we'll meet the person who made this. Internal. Oh, look at that. Welcome. Congratulations. I don't really know where to go with this. Don't listen to the other notes. They're all lies. I'm not safe. That means he's safe. We're gonna read three of these. This one, whoever made this has issues. This one, help, I'm trying to speak. And this one. It's about how this game is pretentious and you all suck. Well, I'm here now. Yeah, we're all here now. There must be a reason for it, though. His terrible secret, he kept it well. I beat the game. How'd you beat? You're not even at the end. More room?
At the end of this level, we're going to see the puzzle again. And here, I'll tell you what I think the puzzle means. Each of these games represents an idea that was on Coda's mind at the time that he was making it. And the puzzle is a way of closing the door on a previous chapter of his life before moving on to the next one.
That could be.
In
I don't
each
care
of his
for
games,
that whispering.
After exploring a theme that, you know, he might find difficult,
Coda
can then place this puzzle that he knows has a reliable solution, he understands exactly how it works, and so it gives him a simple mechanism for moving on.
This puzzle have a solution. Oh my god, I've been here for literally an hour. What the fuck do I do? Help! Help! Does this make sense? The second door won't open. Shit, how do you solve it? Developer answers, please.
And because there's this dark area between the doors, a space between spaces, before you move on,
so
you get to pause. Just for a moment, a few seconds to reflect on and let go of the events that led you here. To step back and connect the pieces together. To grasp at that elusive bigger picture.
Hey, you can stop the whispering now. Now what's that? Typewriter? How do you leave now? Oh my god, it's so loud! All of you need to stop typing. I am here. What do you want? It could be anything. It could be anything. What do you need? Speak! Speak, 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 speak! Oh, you're so loud. Porn stars died too.
Okay, this one is tough. It's gonna kind of just spin
its
own wheels
for
a few minutes. Hang with it.
Okay. Oh, I like this place. It's like very nightclub-esque.
See, like, this is it. The whole game. And there's nothing that's particularly interesting about it. You just walk to the end of a hallway.
Is this a well
Except
I just saw?
For some reason, Coda gets really fixated on this prison that has all of this modern furniture. And I don't know why, but he decides he needs to revisit this prison. He's gonna start over, use the same assets, turn it into something else.
Okay,
cool. Here's version 2.
Version 2. There's nothing here. What furniture ought to go in the center of the room? How about a TV with surround sound? That is not a TV. Okay, now what about the long... Where the hell is my TV? Let's put a huge picture of a horse. Horses. That's not a horse. Why are you asking me these questions? Put live Tesla coils in each corner. Yeah. You're no fun. Pretty sure none of my choices are making any difference. Nope. Okay.
There's a big bit more to this one, but still, it's not really communicating anything. It's kind of just weird for weirdness's sake.
I like it, though. It's different. It's weird. How far does it go?
So, okay, he throws it out and starts over. This time he comes at the prison idea from a different direction.
Hello, please walk forward. This guide will enable you to escape any prison environment. Follow the instructions carefully. Take what you remember. Take care that you remember each step. There's the three dots again. First, click on this table. Got it. Go to the photo frame and click to turn it slightly. Got it. Now turn the floor lamp in this room off, then turn it back on. Off, on. Left side sofa, move it over a little bit. Finally, touch the shelves. That's it. In a real prison, the escape will now open. Return to the start and take it back to your prison. So the table, photo, on, off, left sofa, shelves. Beat me up, Scotty. And now there's
and
no
table. And of course, now the table is gone and you can't begin the chain of events to escape.
There's no photo.
Here's
either.
A version where there are no bars, but you can't actually get to the well. And then a version where the inside of the prison is the outside and the
what
outside
the
is the inside. Let me just blink you real quick.
I like this version better.
I mean, he really unloaded on this prison idea.
Prison
this
in the well.
A dozen of them. Personally, I think it's awful to watch this. To see a person basically
there's the puzzle.
Unraveling through their work. And for what? Like, at what point do you just go, maybe there are game ideas other than this
what
prison that could be working?
Shit?
But Coda doesn't have that voice telling you to stop. That particular mechanism
Whoa.
Of defense against yourself. Without it, you just spiral. And so he keeps going and going and going and going and going. And then he hits on something.
Finally.
And he likes it. And that's it. He's done. He stops making prisons. This is the very last version of the prison game that he created. And the reason I think it works is that the prison is not actually in it.
So it's not a prison game? We're outside. Is it a maze? Oh no. It's not a maze. There's a lamppost, but does that mean this is the end? Okay, we're gonna go to the phone booth. Hello? Ghostbusters? Hello? Who is this? Hey, it's me. I'm you from after you escaped the prison. What? You're me? So you were trapped in this prison too? I like how he just accepts it.
It's a conversation. And so this is what Coda wants, is to be able to talk to someone, to share what's on his mind, and to get some good advice from someone who knows.
Okay.
But the irony is that even in this scenario, you're still talking to yourself.
That's where I am right now.
You know,
I'm so glad to know
all
that
of these games so far are Coda talking to himself.
What's it like to escape? It feels like being completely still and wildly emotional at the same time. Do you feel any different? Sometimes I'm scared that I'll get out and then things will be exactly the same as before. It actually does change. I don't feel like the same person at all. That's so nice to hear. That makes me feel really happy. Age just kind of does that, you know? Wait, if you're me, then did you get a call from another version of you when you were trapped? No, I think I'm the first person to call back. Can you tell me how to get out? Maybe I can come find you. What do I have to do? To get out, you need to tell me how you feel right now. Yeah, I'd be like, what, dude? That will free me? How does that work? You can't know until you're out, but I promise it works. I promise it works. Just tell me your feelings. I feel afraid that nothing will ever change.
Go on. That's it?
I can see why he considers this a fitting conclusion to the prison games. After all of the obsession and frustration, just to be told by someone you can trust that things are going to be okay, wouldn't that be nice?
That'd be awesome. Some loud-ass crickets, though.
So what would it look like if Coda wanted to make a game about talking to someone other than himself?
I don't know, but oh, this is lovely. That is a cool house.
To me, this
house.
Environment is meant to represent Coda's puzzle, with the two doors on either side and a dark transitional space between.
I'll go into the house first. Oh, well, looks like I'm in the house now. Someone spilled juice on your table. Oh, hello. Clean. Well, my goodness, I'm glad as all heck that you showed up. Thought I might have to clean this entire house up by myself. Might be miserable that would have been. Everyone knows lonesome homes make lonely homes.
You'll notice that the quality of the art is a step up from previous.
Don't worry
games,
about me. A place
this
nice, I'll be glad to stay here all night.
System, which he started using from this point on.
Well, now you just might be getting a little ahead of yourself there now.
Into the visual.
Why don't we start cleaning and then you decide whether you can do it all night? I'll finish up here.
Result.
In the meantime, could you please clear the table? Okay. Much nicer. That's the table I want to see. Now, would you please run to the bedroom and make the bed? Yeah. Look at this bed. Oh, much nicer. While you're in there, why don't you straighten out that rug a little bit? Look at that rug. All the little details matter. Do you enjoy being a house cleaner? Well, I don't enjoy it so much as I need it. While I'm working, I feel kind of calm the rest of the pit of my ribcage. My soul just can't be soothed any other way, it seems. Which I guess is about all that matters. Oh, that and the tiny couch. Would you straighten out the pillows and stuff over there? Oh, why, certainly, good sir. Let me do that for you. Oh dear, looks like someone spilled a drink by the couch. Maybe mop that up as long as you're over there. Look at that. I feel compelled to share an incredibly cheesy personal insight. You okay with that? Make it especially cheesy, please. Do it. Do it. What do you mean, no? No, it's not stupid. You gotta say it. Hey, these dishes need to be washed. Why don't you come do that? There we go, I'll clean. Last I checked, that tub needed a cleaning. How about you scrub down the best you can? Much cleaner. No need to be perfect, we're all just human. Are there still books scattered on the floor in the bedroom? If so, would you put them back on the shelf? Fix these books. Perfect. Now then, how about you come clean these dishes off the table? What the
fuck? After the intense
fuck?
Set of prison games, this house cleaning level almost feels like cleansing. It's the moment after a particularly difficult or traumatic experience where you just need to let it sit and digest inside of you.
Are all these
and eventually coherent?
Are all
something
this easy
meaning.
To clean? Darling, let me tell you something. In your lifetime, you're going to clean a lot of houses, and among all those, a few of them will stick out as truly wonderful, beautiful experiences, and none of them will be the ones that were easy. Just something to think about as you smooth out the rug in the bed. God! Damn it.
I know that Coda really liked this game. Of all of his work, actually, this was the only one that he called me up to ask me to come over and
look at. Looks like Tub's gotten rather dirty.
This was during
a period
of a few months where he was, like, grossly happy all the time. Just walked around with a constant smile on his face.
Earlier when I said a really cheesy thought, I was going to say that it occurs to me that one's house is a lot like one's soul. You take care of it, and it takes care of you. That is true. Don't know why I felt so weird about saying that. But there's a bit of truth in it, no? Anyway, so, housekeeping. Let's keep doing this. Books. Would you please clean up the books? Thanks. Yeah, I can do that. Oh goodness, those pillars on the couch are a real mess.
I'm glad he
go
made
and straighten
it.
Them up a bit. Can't have these folks coming over to a messy couch. I wonder who's unstraightening this shit. Question. Answer.
But,
do you enjoy
of course,
this?
It can't
okay,
last.
You're gone.
The music stops, your companion is gone, it's time to leave. The door at the top of the hill is now open as well. Again, you can't stay in the dark space for too long. You just can't. You have to keep moving. It's how you stay alive.
Is there a subliminal message there, sir? Hello, Lampos. You're my only beacon.
Which is the whole point of the puzzle doors, right? That sooner or later you have to pick up and move. I really thought that was the point of it.
Maybe it's not, though. I feel like you're rushing into these things. Items you love at members only price. Why did you come here today? I don't know. Was it to improve your life? Maybe. Was it to get a better job? I'd love that. Was it to make your relationships more meaningful? No. Okay. You came here to be perfect. Oh, well, I'm over here now. This workshop is going to teach you how to be perfect. I want your friends, the people in your life, to look at and think, wow, this person's a better human being than I am. Right now, who do you think about that in your own life? I like how your head spins as you talk. Who do you know who is so well developed as a person that they make you feel disgusted with yourself, compared to whom you feel useless, selfish, ungrateful? I intend to make you into that person. Perfection is within your grasp. And the question is not how we do it, but how we do it effortlessly. This is easy. It is so easy. It is so easy.
About halfway through the game,
being perfect,
perspective
is effortless.
Shifts.
Oh, God!
And
why?
You play as the teacher. And suddenly, you discover that your teacher is just as bigoted and afraid as you are.
This
oh, and also
key.
You can move around the classroom now.
Black move. How do I achieve it with no effort? You better be listening. If it isn't effortless, then it's not the right answer. Drinking is not hurting my life. What? Do you understand that you won't be happy until you love me? This is for you. You, I'm developing a cyst. Gross. Anyone want to do some ecstasy after this? Holy shit, you guys. Something's coming out of the back of the room. Look out! Gumfrey is going to destroy you.
I fell pretty hard for this one.
Perfection.
I feel like it's one of the most relatable experiences that you can have. To assume that some other person is perfect and totally fulfilled in every way and completely miss all of the little flaws that make them painfully human. I think about this game a lot these days.
I would too after an experience like that. Alright, now we're in 2010, eh? Got one more year?
This one took a lot longer than all the others for Koda to make. It was 4 months between this and the last one. That's twice as long as it took him to make any other game before this. And it's not like it's particularly complex, so I remember I found
that
a
lot of assets
strange at the time.
Am I on stage? Oh, God. Hello! The performance is beginning. Places, please. I don't know my place. I'm sorry. I haven't rehearsed. You'll be playing as me. We are gathering professionals. First, you start out leaning against the wall. Oh, yeah. All right, let's do that. Just like that. Good. Stay right there. Back to the wall. Oh. The woman across the room in this chair is a professional photographer of animals. It is your dream to photograph animals professionally. This is your one chance to learn something from her, to gain something, to succeed. Go on, say something to her. Hello. You are wise, happy, focused, and successful. Where is the bathroom? What are you doing? You're deflecting. You're not saying what's actually on your mind.
stop dancing around and have a conversation with this person. Do it again. I like you. No, that's not what I said to her at all. You're completely missing the tone of the conversation. I was reserved, but I knew what I wanted. I was confident. For some reason, it was just one moment, but I was confident. Maybe this is what you need a better feeling. There were a lot of people around us. I'll give you some props to work with. These cones that bounce when you touch them represent people nearby. Oh! Now talk to her again. I'll talk to her in a minute. You're really pushed, too. Where'd you go? There you are. Alright. You must have worked really hard to get where you are. You're messing it all up again. I thought that made sense! You'll freak out if conversation gets personal. That personal that quickly. Do you not realize how important this was for me? I'll never get another opportunity like this. Everything was riding on this. I want to try something. Try stepping back from this. Oh. Bye, lady. Bye, everybody. There's my lamppost. I'm gonna go by my lamppost. He's my only friend. Oh, do I keep going? Okay, whoa. Am I not allowed back on stage? I thought I was doing a good job. Fine, I'll just go this way. Okay, yes, now this is working. This is
the game ends
like.
With this eerie premonition of what's going to happen next in Coda's life. The solution to social anxiety, to fears of having
really
to perform
wonderful.
And having to chase success, the answer for Coda is to withdraw, to hide himself away. Which is what leads to scenarios like the stairs that slowed you down several games ago, where
great.
It just becomes harder and harder to access Coda's inner landscape because he keeps retreating. He just keeps backing away from possible connections to anyone other than himself. And to be honest, I didn't consider it very healthy when I first played this game. You know, it looks to me like he was trying to justify the idea of just disconnecting yourself from the world. And that wasn't what I wanted for him or for his games. Because I feel like a lot of his games are inviting me to connect with this person, to bring him closer.
I felt like I was backing into something.
But what
there.
Can you do? After this, Coda went off and took another 5 months to make a new game.
June, it's my birthday. To play this game properly, you must keep your eyes closed. Click to begin the game. Okay. Eyes are closed. Am I supposed to be guided by sound? I don't know where to go. Hello? 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 What happened? Let me start over?
You should probably open your eyes if you haven't already. It's
okay.
Pretty much impossible to solve otherwise. And there is a solution, by the way.
Oh, God. There's a giant door. Research. Blind. Ah! Find the shields! Where's the shields? There's a lamppost up there. Speak to something that is honest. I can't keep making these. Yes, that's it. That's the truth. I'm out of ideas.
Like I said, I was getting concerned. First off, he's never been this explicit in his work about exactly what he's thinking. So, where's that coming from? But then, even weirder, his work has potentially stopped being an outlet for him.
I haven't.
Not
been
like
honest.
He's having trouble iterating on ideas, but he literally just can't think of new ideas anymore. And in person, he was being a lot more distant than usual. Like, you know how sometimes a person will just deflect anything that you say in order to keep themselves disconnected all the time? It was that kind of thing. Here was the point in my relationship with Koda where I really started to wonder if he needed my help in some way. His games are going to get more desperate from here on out.
It seems like
after this game, it's almost 6 months before he finishes something new.
Damn, Christmas time.
Hello. That's what I would say first. Oh, hello. Hello, is anyone there? Is that a person? How lovely. It's been a long time since I talked to anyone. Dot, dot, dot. What's wrong? You look lost. I'm completely out of ideas. Oh no! What's happened? Did something change? There was a machine that kept me going, and it stopped. Oh, I like that. Wait, you're looking for a machine? I think I know where it is. It isn't far. I need to see it to know why it stopped. There's a problem.
If the last game featured Koda talking explicitly about his creative frustrations, this one turns it up to 11.
Deal.
Now, put yourself in my shoes playing this. Here's a friend whose work is exhibiting signs of struggle, frustration, anxiety, depression, even.
I'll show it to you.
And yet, still, he keeps making games. He keeps throwing himself into the grinder even when he clearly doesn't have the energy for it anymore.
Well, this puzzle's easy.
Why? What is it for?
I saw this puzzle before.
From my perspective at the time, and just what I knew of him, this was a result of how
isolated
he was.
Can you tell me how to do it?
He was in his own little bubble, just sitting at his computer all day, not really showing these games to anyone, not releasing them onto the internet. And so he didn't have anyone outside of himself to connect with. He had no outlet to ground himself on.
Just press the switch here. There you go.
You can't talk yourself out of loneliness. It doesn't work that way. You can't be the one writing both the questions and the answers. Then there's no movement. Then there's no circulation. If all of your anxieties are being channeled into your work, then if the work ever fails, you have no backup and you're just going to crash.
That's true, but, oh. Here we are. What are you, these are just some, there's no machine here. You'll see. You have to say that your work is fun and easy. You have to say that game development is simple and joyous, that you love it 100% of the time. Alright, making games, okay. But it wasn't true. Don't worry about it, just keep talking. Keep saying that creation is easy. It is easy, it never stops being easy.
Seeing this game at the time that he made it, it looked really unhealthy to me. I was watching him do this to himself, and I hated it. I hated seeing him so trapped. It's like, video games are not worth this amount of suffering.
Please, where is the machine?
This is someone I really cared about. And I used to get so much joy out of seeing him create. For him to suddenly become angry and frustrated like this, it was the worst thing for me. I don't know. This is what I felt at the time. I don't know how else to explain it. I wanted it to stop more than anything. I had never felt so rotten. I needed more than I had ever needed anything for this to stop.
Oh my gosh, there's someone in there. Well, I guess not anymore.
But it didn't stop. After finishing this one, Coda takes another 7 months and comes up with a new game.
All right, last year, 2011. Not last year, as in last year of them being made. As, oh, hello, sir. I like the crow. Oh, ma'am, glad to see you arrived safely. We've captured the machine. It's waiting for you now. You begin the interrogation whenever you like. I intend to be brutal. No, I intend to be quick. Very good. Just be warned that someone called the press, so we might have a bit of attention on this one. Also, one more thing you should know about the machine. It calls itself Coda. Okay. Hello, press. Whoa, I'm gonna get to see the machine. Man, can you give us some answers? Do you know where these poisonous games have come from? You just keep facing that way. You stopped.
And of course, it's the machine.
Your work was keeping... you stopped feeding us. Look at that. You need to go to the people who are out there and apologize to them. No, nothing. Which is just the press. It falls on me to deliver bad news. The machine will not apologize to us. We will find a way to live without it. We do not need its games. Let us show it that we are not failures. Follow me. We will destroy everything the machine has created. Now we're back here. Oh, the door's gone. Oh, shit. Ah! Destroy it all. All of it. Never-ending destruction! Not the floor, though, because that would be too much. Yeah, you too.
So now the work is becoming self-destructive.
Literally.
At the time that I first played this game, shortly after he made it, here's what I'm thinking to myself. I'm thinking that Code is stuck in his own head, and that it's having a very negative effect on him, and that all he needs to do is just start showing his work to people, to get some actual feedback on his games. It might get him out of isolation.
Maybe he's not actually in isolation. Ah, the typewriters!
So, as I'm thinking this, I realize that I could be the one to initiate it. Because it would never occur to Coda to start actively soliciting feedback, so what if I did it for him? If he could see the difference it would make,
yeah, but if he doesn't want
conversations
that...
conversations with other human beings, would that bring him out of his mental spiral? Would it give him confidence in himself? Would it bring meaning back into his work?
If he doesn't want that, then don't push him. That's the thing about... introverts and extroverts. Introverts don't always want that kind of attention, yet you give it to them. Oh, okay.
So I started showing Koda's work to people.
Destroy
I took this one,
all.
And the islands which you just played, the theater, the notes, the house cleaning game, and some of the prison escape games. I brought them to people that I knew and trusted. I asked their opinions. And the great part is that they really loved his games. You know, the point of it all was just to give him some external reference point, but they genuinely loved his work. There was nothing for him to be afraid of.
He might not be afraid, he just doesn't want to put himself out there. Which is fine.
Do I have to destroy the machine now?
Put down your weapon.
How do I put it down? I don't want to shoot you. Oh,
E. Can you see
shoot?
Why I felt like this was the right thing to do?
Sorry, Koda.
This is the thing that I always feel like I need. To be told that my work is good. That I am good.
Yeah, but that's
when
you.
When someone really connects with a thing that I've made, when they see themselves purely in my work, there's nothing that feels better. And I got to give that very same feeling to my friend. I did something. I really felt like
this
I did something
huge
good.
Turn.
Like I was a good person. I felt like there was a friend who was in trouble and was unhappy and maybe didn't like themselves, and I could fix it. If I could give him this gift, maybe I could fix the problem. When they told me how much they enjoyed his games, it was the best feeling. It was the absolute best feeling. It made me feel so happy.
Yeah, but
so
he probably didn't want them shown. Those are your feelings. Not his. Yeah, this took a huge turn.
So anyway, Koda finishes this game, and then really he just kind of takes off for a while. So this is June of 2011, and I didn't hear anything from him for several weeks, I guess. And so out of nowhere, one day I get an email, and it's got a private link to a new game of Koda's. This one is called The Tower, and to my knowledge, it's the last game that Koda ever made.
No
so
boy.
Let's take a look.
Yeah. Something's gonna happen in the tower. June again, it's my birthday. The tower. No inspirational quote that time, like porn stars die? A lovely tower.
I
take
this
back
is
what
where
I said
I have
about
trouble
lovely
saying
tower.
Anything meaningful about Koda's work. Because more than anything else, the tower just feels distant. It feels like it's trying to distance itself from the world. It's a very cold game.
I think it might have been meant just for you then. Oh my gosh.
This room actually has a maze in it.
Does it? I don't see it. The fuck?
Except that all the walls of the maze are invisible. And then, every time you touch one of the walls, there's this awful flashing and noise, so the experience is really miserable. The game goes beyond not being meant to be played, it actually seems to despise the player for trying to play it at all. But I do want to show you the rest of the levels, so when you're ready to continue, press enter, and I'll put a bridge over the maze.
That'd be nice, because I don't... Oh, lovely Stanley Parable bridge here. I don't want to figure out this maze. Way too long. Lovely chanting you got
and to
back
be fair,
there about.
It's not like this is the first game that's needed some modification to be playable. Like the house cleaning game. You know, that one used to actually loop the cleaning chores and you just cleaned a house forever.
So you changed that
I
one
had
too?
To cut it off so that you could exit the house and the game would actually end. But that game had an idea that it was actually trying to communicate.
See, that was
what's
the thing,
deeper
is,
idea behind the invisible maze?
He made the games, why do they have to be endable, and you're ending them.
The only way past this challenge is to randomly guess the 6-digit code.
Oh, God.
Like the invisible maze, it's frustrating to me, because it's the opposite of everything else that Koda has made. It doesn't encourage thought or engagement. It doesn't ask anything of me, except a lot of my time.
I'd say a lot of time.
If I could have reached him during this time, then maybe I could have asked him, but I couldn't. I still don't really understand why this is here. I'll put the code on the ground for you here, though, so that we can move on.
Thank God. 151617. Oh, that's not bad. 111567.
The switch to open this door is actually on the other side of the door, meaning that it's literally impossible to solve from this side.
Oh, so I just trapped myself.
If you somehow brute-forced your way through the first two challenges, and you got to this point, there's actually just no way to progress. And it's scary for me, the idea of Koda cutting himself off entirely, just saying, you know, that's it, that's the end of the conversation, not giving me any way to fix the problem. I feel like a failure, I guess, when I can't fix the problem.
See, I think you were pushing yourself too hard on him.
I can open this door for you, so let me do that.
And he was trying to push you away because he didn't want that.
Was I a failure for not understanding this game? I mean, I don't know why I would be. It's not like everything needs to have a solution, but I feel it somehow. I feel like I failed, and I don't understand why. I remember, it's June of 2011. I'm playing this for the very first time. And as I'm playing, I'm thinking to myself, I don't know this person. I have no idea who this person is.
You probably don't.
It wasn't the guy I knew. It wasn't my friend. I had come to so many conclusions from looking at all of his work up to this point, and then suddenly none of them... I had been trying to, though. That was the thing. For years, I was trying to get to know him, to understand who he actually was and what he stood for. I asked him so many times to please just tell me what his games mean to him. I asked him please to tell me what the three dots mean.
Yeah, what do the three dots mean?
And he wouldn't. I just felt so strongly that if I could have connected with him, that if I could have somehow made his work my own, that I would finally be once and for all happy. It was that I needed to see myself in someone else. I needed to be someone other than me.
See, that's the problem.
But he stopped and left. And it felt somehow like I had failed.
You pushed yourself too hard onto him, and he didn't want that. But you kept trying. You gotta be careful. You gotta be careful with people sometimes. It's understandable. Dear Davey, thank you for your interest in my games. I need to ask you not to speak to me
anymore. I'm the reason that you stopped making games, aren't I?
Yeah.
It's because of what I did.
Yeah.
I poisoned it for you.
A little bit. Just a little bit.
I don't think I ever told you this.
A hundred times whether you think
but when I took your work and I was showing it to people, it actually felt... It felt as though I were responsible for something important and valuable.
The hell? You've so infected my personal space that
the people who played them, they treated me like I was
important.
They really listened and cared about what I had to say. Even though I was showing your work, it was... I felt good about myself. Finally, for a moment, while I had that, I liked myself.
I'm sorry. If there was an answer, meaning would it make you any happier? Would you stop taking my games and showing them to people against my wishes? See, I kind of figured after a while he didn't want this. Giving them something that is not yours to give, violating the one boundary that keeps me safe. He liked his solitude, and you pushed him too hard. Would you stop changing my game? Stop adding lampposts to them. So you put those in.
Oh my goodness.
This game took a huge turn.
you simply
and then you stopped. And I didn't have anything left to show people. I just had to be with myself. And as soon as that happened, there was no feeling at all. Nothing. Less than nothing.
Oh, man.
What does that mean?
When I'm around you, I feel physically ill. You desperately need something, and I cannot give it to you. I literally do not have it. Struggling to come up with new ideas is not making me depressed. Low points are just part of the process. See, I think you stressed out over this guy because he slowed down on making games, but just because he hit writer's block. The fact that you think I am frustrated or broken says more about you than me. Oh. I realize that this doesn't make sense to you just yet. Which is fine, you're not my problem to solve. But I do hope that one day it clicks and that you make peace with it, this thing you are wrestling.
I'm afraid that I did something really stupid because I don't like myself.
And when you finally see what I am talking about, don't say anything.
That's why I'm releasing this collection of your work.
Oh, there's no...
Is because I haven't been able to find any other way to reach you. I've tried everything. And so a part of me has hope that if I put this compilation out into the world, and if I put my name on it, that maybe enough people will play it so that it'll find its way to you, so that I can tell you that I'm sorry. I know I screwed up.
He's trying
if
to fix it.
I apologize to you, truly and deeply.
Is that getting closer?
Will you start making games again? Please, I need to feel okay with myself again.
That's
and I always
closer.
Felt okay as long as I had your work to see myself in.
It's closing
in. I mean, is something wrong with me? Because I know that I did an awful thing, and I'm doing it again right now. Like, I'm showing people your work, but I can't stop myself from doing it. That's how badly I need to feel something again. Like, I'm an addict. There has to be something wrong with me. Can I apologize? What if I tell you I was wrong? Will that work? Will that fix it? I don't know. I don't think it will, but there's nothing else that I can do. Just tell me what you want. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Please. Start making games again. Please help me. Please give me some of whatever it is that makes you complete. I want whatever that wholeness is that you just summoned out of nothing and you put into your work. You were complete in some way that I never was. And I want to know how to be a good person. I want to know how not to hate myself. Please. I'm fading and all I want is to know that I'm going to be okay.
Game took a turn. Well, that's the ceiling. I am at a loss for words. I don't even know how to interpret this anymore.
More love, more praise, more people telling me that I'm good. Always more. It's like a disease. Solution.
I am at a complete loss for words. I don't even know.
I guess if someone had told me ahead of time that he just really enjoyed making prison games, maybe I wouldn't have thought he was so desperate. Wouldn't have told so many people that he was depressed. Maybe he just likes making prisons.
Which is nothing wrong with that. It's a good puzzle. That balcony makes no sense. There's no way to get up there.
Even now, the disease is telling me to stop. Don't show people what a shitty person you are. They'll hate you.
Where am I?
foundation.
If I knew that my life depended on finding something to be driven by other than validation, what would that even be? It's strange, but the thought of not being driven by external validation is unthinkable. Like, I actually cannot conceive of what that would be like. What now? I think I need to go.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry, because I know that I said that I would be here and I would walk you through this, but...
No, that's okay.
I'm starting to feel like I have a lot of work to do.
I think you do, too.
I have a lot that I need to make up for.
Yeah.
So I'm...
Yeah.
Just gonna...
I can make it through here.
Okay.
I can make it through here just fine. You need some work to do. I don't even know what to say anymore. Down the hall. Oh, it's an elevator. I did not expect this type of emotion from this game, because the Stanley Parable played a lot with your minds and what you thought could work and what you thought you could test and push the boundaries of. This played a lot more with your emotions, and I think it did a great job. Stairs. We gotta almost be done. Is that the beam from the start? Let's do it. We're gonna jump in. Oh, we hit a bug. Again. And now it's just black. Oh. Wow. That is awesome. And that's the center of it.
Turn back from this cave.
so that's the beginner's guide. I think it took a different turn from the Stanley Parable, because instead of playing with your mind, this one played more with your emotions. And I think they did a great job on it. I'm at a complete loss for words. I don't even know what to say about it. If you have your own interpretation, I'd love to hear it. Please leave a comment about it. If you like the video, hit that like button. And I really want to keep playing more games like this. And if you want to see more games like this, please hit that subscribe button. I'm still building up my channel and stuff like that, so it's going to look a little rough for a while, but I'm working on it. Just stick with me if you can, alright? Thank you guys so much for watching, and I want to see what happens at the end here, just in case. No, it just goes right back to the beginning. Okay. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Again, if you liked it, hit that like button, and yeah, I will see you guys in the next one of whatever I make. I'm just at a loss for words. I don't even know what to say. I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.